Mass layoffs continue. The jobless surprise, which is really not a surprise. COCA-COLA, 2,200 job cuts. 3 out of 4 small businesses need federal aid. Folks, this is a big mess, and it's only going to get worse. Hey, everybody. My name is JJ. You're watching Bull to the Bust. It is Friday, December 18th, 2020. I hope you're well, and I wish I had better news for you, but we need to prepare for reality because things are not going to get better. Let's get into the news. Now, if you've been on this channel, you knew this was going to happen. Things were just going to continue to get worse. We reported months ago that lockdown 2.0 was going to happen, and it was going to deepen the recession, Great Depression, that we're already well into right now. No long-term solutions are being discussed. No systemic changes are being discussed. The bankers are just trying more of the same failed policies that got us into this mess. And it's more debt, more stimulus, more propping up of the market bubbles, more increasing the cost of living, and it's going to be more dependent people, more dependent population, more dependent businesses. Let's get into it. This one comes out of Fox. 62% of small business owners fear the worst is yet to come. And down here, 74% of small business owners say they need further federal assistance. That's basically 3 out of 4 businesses, right? So if it weren't for the rescue programs and this assistance, imagine 3 out of 4 businesses failing right now. 3 out of 4 stores that you go to would not exist if it weren't for the rescue programs. Now, of course, it's the Walmarts, the Home Depots. They're going to be just fine. It's not going to be those included. And I'll bet you anything that the 25% of businesses that don't need federal aid are the mega corporations, the multinationals, the too big to fails. And small businesses, the little guy, the mom and pop shop, continue to get crushed. And I'm not going to be surprised if after all this plays out that 3/4 of the U.S. population is going to be on some sort of assistance right now. Right now it's about 50%. Of the population is on some sort of federal program, right? When you combine unemployment, food programs, other federal aid, housing assistance, I mean, it's already a huge portion of the population. It's going to continue to get worse and worse and worse until finally it's only going to be the top 10% that run everything and own everything, and the bottom 90% is going to be just living on handouts and assistance. Right? That is seriously, it sounds crazy, that is seriously the direction that we're headed in this country and actually most of the world, unless something major changes. All right? And again, no one's talking about major changes. Everyone's talking about keeping the bubbles propped up. We've heard for 4 years bragging about the stock market being propped up, new all-time highs in all the indexes, including the Dow Jones. All right? Why don't we ask the nearly 6 million people, when you look at the rents and the mortgages that are not being paid, ask those 6 million people how they feel about an all-time high stock market. I bet you'll hear that they wish they could pay their rent instead of an all-time high stock market. Well, that 6 million is going to continue to get worse and worse and worse. Why? Because there's no solutions being discussed. Right? There's nothing out there. There's no magic that's going to happen in 2021 to bring this economy out of the gutter. Right, it's going to continue to get worse, and of course there's going to be more excuses. They're going to say, well, we had to lock down more, so now the economy's failing because of it. They're going to say it has nothing to do with the monetary policies, and they're going to say it's nothing to do with the failed policies that they're continuing to do over and over and over again. And do you think when Janet Yellen gets back into the Fed that she's going to make any changes? We've already witnessed what Janet Yellen's going to do. It's going to be lower rates, probably going into negative rates in the not too distant future. More stimulus, more market propping. The Fed's going to come in and buy everything in sight. Right? So come on, do you think anything is really going to change with these people? Here it is, celebrity net worth. She is worth $13 million. And that must be the price tag to pay somebody to keep on destroying the middle class and Main Street. All right, let's talk about this jobless surprise. Here we are again. It was the same thing last week. Oh, it's a surprise number. The jobless claims increased. Nobody expected it, right? On this channel, We all expected it. This is no surprise. This is a non-surprise. But here's the headline. Once again, weekly jobless claims rise unexpectedly. Oh my goodness, unexpectedly. Nobody saw this coming. I was in shock. I almost fell out of my chair. Come on, people. We know this is going to continue to get worse. The number of first-time unemployment benefits filing last week, 885,000. And that's the most since September 5th. The economists that were polled by Dow Jones expected initial claims to fall. Right? Isn't it funny how the quote-unquote economists seem to always get it wrong? And I watch most of my economic news now on YouTube, and I would trust an analysis from a middle-class YouTuber before I would trust these mainstream economists that you're seeing on the boob tube there. And you're going to be seeing a lot more signs like this, businesses going under, and it's going to be mostly small businesses. But we're also seeing some layoffs on the higher end as well. Let's talk about COCA-COLA and a couple other companies. 2,200 jobs cut from COCA-COLA worldwide under a restructuring plan. With a lot of the restaurants, the bars, and the nightclubs shut down, the soft drink industry is taking a big hit. There is a lot of people that work for this company, and it's just going to be thousands of additional people in the unemployment line begging for a check. And it's actually about 1,200 of these jobs are here in the U.S., and they're going to use layoffs and buyouts to eliminate those 1,200 jobs. Right? And that accounts for about 12% of the workforce. That is a big, big layoff. All right, but no problem, right? Because the stock market continues to make new highs. All right, the wealth gap is going to continue to increase until the whole population is begging for monthly payouts, monthly checks. Probably universal basic income will be here in the very near future. And I think this has been the plan all along, to get everyone dependent. And a dependent population is a obedient population. Right, so now in order to get your check that you're dependent on, you're going to have to do whatever they say. You're going to get the shot. You're going to not criticize, you know, the people in control, and you're going to watch your step, and you're going to you're not going to own anything, and you are going to be happy, right? We've heard that before. A recent article here out of Reuters: 3M to cut 2,900 jobs in restructuring. The entertainment industry getting blasted. Tom Cruise is pretty worried about the movie industry, if you saw him yelling at his staff, where he was talking about how many people are employed in the entertainment industry, in the movie industry. Universal Orlando notifies 1,100 employees they'll be laid off by the end of the year. So here in just a couple weeks, these people are going to be where? In the unemployment line, waiting for a check. Right, and you have all these layoffs in a economy, the U.S. economy, that's 75% service sector. A lot of these people don't have any real skills except for service skills, right? Ticket takers, people that serve food and drinks, a lot of the retail workers. And if these workers weren't already replaced by robots and AI, well, now they're just going to get laid off, it looks like. The travel industry getting decimated. Southwest Airlines to lay off nearly 400 in Las Vegas alone. If there's 400 just in Las Vegas, imagine what this is going to be nationwide. We're talking about probably tens of thousands of jobs that are going to be lost. Right now, sure, they're going to try to keep the airline industry alive and with bailouts and life support, but what kind of airline is going to stay in business when most of the customers are destitute and dependent on a paycheck, depending on a handout? Right, so with no change in course being discussed, the dollar dropped now, a 2.5-year low for the dollar. Gold continues to get bid up. I expect gold to be at 2,500 by the middle of 2021. I expect silver to keep climbing. Yes, there will be volatility. There will be ups and downs. But we're going to see higher highs and higher lows. We saw silver run up to, I believe, about $28, drop back down to about $23. The next run up, I expect $35, probably by mid-2021. unless something huge happens, of course. Be careful out there. Be prepared for the swan. Maybe it'll be a black swan. Maybe it'll be a white swan. Be prepared for it. Everybody, thanks for watching. Stay safe. Stay well. Let me know what you think down in the comments. How many people out there expected this economy to actually recover? I doubt most of you believed the myth, believed the fairy tale that this economy was going to somehow be pulled out of the gutter with the same methods or the same rescue programs that are being implemented right now. But do most people believe this fable? I mean, you let me know, please. Thanks everybody for watching. I appreciate your support. Thank you for sharing these videos. I see that the Twitter shares, the Facebook shares are up. Thank you very much for being here, for sharing, for engaging, for your comments, for your words of encouragement and feedback. Thank you to all my Patreons and everyone watching today. Thank you very much. Again, stay safe, stay well, stay prepared. Until next time, bye for now. Peace.